Hey guys, as you can see, I do have a heater that is temperature controlled. Not everybody likes those. Not everybody says you need them. I say you do. But I am picky about the quality of my solder joints. All right, guys, what we're doing today is we're switching out the pickups on this guitar to some different pickups. Let's go ahead and quickly do the first step here. I'm gonna put my screws I remove in there. First stage. And the pickups hook up 100% to this switch. So this is the only thing we don't wanna mess with today.
You're talking?
I'm doing a video.
Oh, you seen
your
wallet?
No. Over. Don't worry. Don't ruin my video and be rude. An asshole for some reason. Okay, let's take these off. Very rude person. I don't know why she does that. Another container here. Go ahead and put them here. And this driver has a spinning end that allows you to put pressure and spin the unit with two different hands, which is like having it as a driver, a hand tensioned driver. Very precise, and it does take more time to use this tool, but you can be very gentle with this tool. I think these will all be the same. Looks like it. Next step, come back over here. You got loose, I know. Come out, I know. Right here. We have a bridge ground. And a hot and a coil tap right here. Coil tap and a hot. Right? That's for the bridge. Then we have a neck. Ground. Coil tap. This cat is being nasty sounding coughs. Hang around. Okay. Pull these out straight. Clip them or anything like that. I'm just gonna pull them out. I'm not really gonna prepare them anyway, but I will do this. Most people won't do this, but I'll do this. Just removed them. I'll take them out and do this to them. A retin. There. There. Now, if you go to insert them in something, they're gonna go in a single solder instead of a flux and solder. You know the flux that is when shit doesn't want to solder. So it's going to help it solder right away. If I go to put it in something or put it back in here or whatever, it's going to be easy. Now, all you do is you start a little bit, push it against, add a little bit. Push it against, add a little bit. Push it against, add a bunch because it's bare wire. No, that's the right wire. So it doesn't matter. Just make sure that the wires are retinned. And then now I'll pull them straight. Okay. And make sure they're not too wrapped around anything in here. Pull that around. And pull this around these. This is the volume. to output, the volume knob to tone, and the volume knob to the, that guy, this guy's come out, okay? Very cool. Let's clean these up real quick. Excess off of the tool. So again, there we go. And we got three nice flat, well, clean spots. Another, ooh, dropping it down here. Another one. Ooh, these have a through hole. Should be using the through hole, but whatever. There we go. Should I add a little bit more over here? Little box. There we go. Now those six pads are primed and ready. These pads here look bubbled and clear and crystally. Got a little bit of a burn there, but nothing big. Flip this back around. Now these pickups are loose and they're ready for Lisa Wabas. Here we go. Surgery. That's how it always is. Just nice and easy, slide out the part you no longer are going to have inside of you. And there it is, it's out. There's always something that comes along with it. There you go. Oops. This can all be cut to one length right here. These wires, fine. But I'll be cut about one length. So I'll prep these before I put them in the fucking guitar. So let's do it. Twist it around, red and white, twist them around each other. There we go. Now, pick up a sitting here, in a position where, there we go. Those are nice and sitting there, easy peasy. Be able to grab with my pinky if I need to, more like this. There we go. So, shed some light. They all look, the main lead can handle a little bit more. There you go. They all look glassy. Very good. Very good. Pull them straight. twist them a little bit. This will help guide them through. Real nice, right there. Like that. Right there. Like that. Okay. Is that what's going on? Looks like it is. Night pickup goes through here. Okay, cool. So take the night pickup, put the night pickup in its pickup ring. I keep itching that and forgetting. Okay, pickup ring. Let's use the existing pickup ring hardware. Because it looks like around the same depth, it'll be fine. You're sitting in there nicely. Holding the spring so it doesn't pop off anywhere. It could, it usually won't. Put them down here. Holding the spring, it could pop off. Really less likely this time. Pick it up. Down here. Set this back onto the side again. Driver. Gotcha. One, two, three, four turns is good. Turn it over here, see where it goes. Line's a little bit easier than it did before. Stupid hair, I don't want that in my guitar. Stupid long ass girl hair. Not mine, look at that. Over here. Spot. And now once you get it there. A few twists. Oh. Don't want a thread on this one. Nice. Gotta love that. Just, the thing is, you don't want to do damage. You just take it easy. Just take it easy. Yep. Now, get a nice little height, which would be flat to the top. And flat to the top gives you the least profile from the screw, basically. You can pull it right to the height of the screw. Now you have just the height of the screw. You don't have this thing sticking up further, making it the screw plus. Just trust me, I know what I'm saying. Get this, first thing you do is get this down around the screw properly. Then you feed it in this hole here. So it's gonna come out right here. Once you feed it through this hole, pull it all the way through on this hole. All the way through. While you're getting this pickup in here, keep pulling it so that it's in the right spot. In the end, keep pulling it. But don't pull it too hard, don't pull it wrong. It's tight. There it is. It's there. Okay. Now that that's in and it's tight and it's right, it's there. You've got to get the pickup up a little bit. Let's see. And the pickup will sit in there better. And you can use these, four of these, to remount the ring. And you're going to want to do this before she gets out of whack. So do that. Seems about right. Pretty good. Then lead this in here. The back, if you need to, and double check it's coming out properly. Leave it hanging. Come on back over here. Next pickup. So this was a 59 for the 7. This would be a X2N 7. Use the springs because this guy, yeah, looks a little bit deeper. Not a lot. Pickup ring done. Yeah, nice. It's nice. Just a no pole sticking down, so that's nice for this cable. It looks like it's not threaded. Sweet Caroline. does the cable come out that way? Is it for going up here? Set the standard to go up here to a switch. Maybe. I feel like it's the wrong way. Okay, this guy's going in. Oh wait, am I gonna tune him first? Yes I am. Don't mess around. I'm gonna tune him first, my friend. Then I'm gonna mount it. Don't mess around. I think it's green as ground. Black and white. And Dimarzio are the pair. Let's look. Pick up wiring. Black ice. There we go. Pick up wiring. Dimarzio is red as start, black and white together, green is that with it. Not very different. It's just that the red and black are red. Yeah, the red and black are switched because red is live. Black and white are tied together. And green and ground are tied together. Red is lead. Green and ground are tied together. Red is lead. Okay, so this over here. It's sitting here like this. Mm-hmm. Then you hit. There you go. Magnet grab. Alright. That was wild. And confusing. For a few seconds. Re-tin. Boom. And you can tin after you re-tin. Some extra big leads on these. Dimarzio's here. Where they cut them back like that. And then, some very, what do you say? Temperature sensitive. Melties. Yep. There we go. Put those three together. This over here. Get this gunk off the bottom just because I don't want it's going in here forever. So. This is wax. There we go. Twist them together because damn, that was annoying. Damn, I wanted to come apart. That was weird. There we go. Not a room. This one. Now that I got you, I forgot to mount you. And do it to it. Take one of them. Screw it. Do it. Give me this is bring, geez, that cap. Springs. Almost had you. Almost had you. See if this does it right. Should be right. Should be impossible to be wrong because these are the same screws that were in there. Right? Yeah, that's gotta be right. That's gotta be right. Now I'm pushing the whole spring up. Oh man. I need my shortest screwdriver. Where are you, shortest screwdriver? Gotcha. Got it. So make one height, the screw height. Let's try and get that guy back in. Twice like that. Hey, that's enough. That's just life. Careful on your coat. And remember, it's not the way it goes in, this is the way. Okay. Next step is the short one. Is the neck. This one is the bridge, so the neck pickup. Expose these wires again. Pull you guys back out. There we go. Ground. One, so good. You gotta just pull the stuff around. Nice way to get the tap in place, not touching the wire itself. I'm touching the part of it. Just not touching the direct lead, touching the insulated part. Solder in. Clean the tip. Give it a little check. Everything seems okay. Pull this wire over a little bit. It's ground by ground. Okay. Untwist these. Unfurl these. They're twisted together in a weird way. There we go. First one is the grounds. Do that. One, two. Oh, that case is hot. Don't touch it that way. Careful. You just did the grounds and stuff. Okay. Just wait for this. The face. I'm not supposed to. Some length on that hot. There we go. Everything's all soldered in. Pretty simple. You just drop it in here. These guys can kind of get wrapped up in this cavity. Just no big deal. They don't care. So I get this guy in and get the cap on it. That's the first thing you do. So the first thing you do, get out of sight. Get this cap back on. Easy on it, don't do it wrong. Go, then you'll do the screws because it'll be easier. If you move your hand away, it won't be a big deal. Put these in here, driver. One. There we go. Is that it? That's not it. I'm missing it. You guys think Alec Baldwin's a killer? Is that a stunt to sell more Beetlejuice masks? Just to promote an independent film, get a lot of watches on it. When it comes out, make a lot of money on an independent film. Everyone's watching it because of that. They want to see the scene. Change gun laws. Is he trying to change gun laws? What's he doing it for? All right. That's it. All I can do now is set the pickup height after setting the strings back into the right position. So here we go. Here goes nothing. Nah, not here goes nothing. I forgot. I'm going to add something to this guitar that I added to my other Ibanez RG. So before I get too far, before I create an impossible situation, I've got to solder this in here. Is it already an impossible situation? Well, maybe just sort of, but I'm going to push these wires out of the way and fix that scenario just the way I need to. I'm going to get all these wires over to this area here, and over the course of the ground and output, I believe it is, I'm gonna stick a capacitor. So I'm gonna build that capacitor now, because this capacitor, I don't have any, but here's the back plate, but it's the value I need, and I have stuff to make it. So do this. I forget that all my cool capacitors are in here. What's this one? 22.3, okay, yeah. One, two, three. I need a three. Where's my third one? No biggie. There it is. Bunch of bullet ones. Okay. These blue ones are 224. Yep. 220000 picofarads. So I'm going for 330 is the value. So I'm going to put two in series. Pull these leads out a little bit. I'm going to put two in series. So I'm going to take these and I'm going to twist them together. These leads here. Use my pliers to do it better. Right down there at the base. Then I'm gonna solder that spot. Real easy. Nothing fancy. That takes the value. Careful. That takes the value and makes it not the same value. It makes it half. It doesn't add like a resistor. It halves. That's why it needs to be on. Where are we at? 200? 25? 250? 300? Now 300 again. solder to each other in the center lead. Okay. Short. Take that, put a tiny little piece of heat shrink on it. Clip it. My little miniature scissor I keep on my keychain. In the form of a Swiss Army scissor. If you have those scissors like this. There we go. Finish it. The end. There we go. That's good. Now this is two of them making a half value, and then it's one, and then the values divide by each other, so it becomes like parallel resistors. So this part's cool. At that point, take this guy here and you're gonna twist it in, and you're gonna take this guy over here, do the same thing, pull it down like this, twisting it in, and you'll have two leads sticking down, two leads not. It's the fun part. This is fun. Now you solder these two. There you go, one. And clip the side jutting leads as close as you possibly can. The other one. Right? Get these leads to kind of stick down here a little bit like this. Get this one. So now you got two leads. You can clip them, doesn't matter. A little bit shorter. Right now. Then, one other thing you want to do is you want to cover this thing in insulation. And this is something I like to do because I don't want people to know what it is. Or, since it's my guitar and it's not going anywhere, cover it in insulation, but clear. So I can see what it is and I go, oh, that's what that is. And I'll have to take the insulation off like I did earlier for the other one. Looks like that leaves a little overhang. And the reason I leave an overhang is so I can pitch together. Now here we go. Zap it with the heat. The heat. Get the stick to itself. Real hot. Doesn't stick to itself, you at least just get it so hot that it's like stiff. That's pretty good. It's all right if it does come off by pulling it real hard. There you go. The only contact leads are these two. I'm gonna make sure I'm putting it over the right spot by looking up treble bleed guitar. No, look at my other guitar and look at it, that picture of it, and see where it's at on my other guitar. It's not the ground, it's the two leads, right here. So I think I'll be able to get that to go in there pretty good without messing with anything, just by getting these leads like this. Solder this in. See how it goes. Bunch of solder on the tip. Just a bunch of solder. Just flood it. Wanting to drip off of them out. Come over here to the spot. Is it there? Yeah, and the wire wanted to leave, so that's not cool. Soldering in. Let's drill this again. See if I can get that main lead back in. Jeez, that really went on a wild chase. Careful of your face, it's good crap all over it, dude. Let's try to miss it. Let's try it like this. Got it. Yeah, moves the leads around. Now everything else just has to fit back in here nicely. Be nice. Don't fight. Too easy. Too easy. And these guys go on. That guy goes on. And there's four screws in here. So let's get those four screws from here. Oh, Jesus. Dropping shit all over. Things I was dropping on the screws. This is a bag of resistors for filter circuits for guitars. Weird plug. A couple of weird things that are in here for setting. Variable filter tabs. I haven't done one yet, but I probably should. So I probably would do it. Now, one last thing. Where's the screw? Driver. Screw me, driver. This. Close her all up this time. We'll be getting back into her in another video soon. New switch. It's going to be the Mega Switch M. My Schaller. Which gives you the ability to do the Ibanez RG wiring of the 2000s. That gives you the parallel. It gives you a regular neck, parallel neck. Both pickups in series, both series pickups and standard humbucker series pickups in parallel. Then the inner coils in parallel, then the humbucker, standard bridge humbucker. Well, there you go. Now it's time to tune her up. Hope you guys think that looks cool. Let's get a zoom in on it. Video zoom.